My name is Phillip Beningoso. I'm an investment professional, and I'm going to be discussing how to calculate return on stockholders' equity. Now, return on equity, or stockholders' equity, ROE, is one of the most important financial metrics to consider when evaluating a business for possible investment. Now, it tells you how much profit the company is making with the money invested by stockholders. Let me give you a couple of steps here for calculating and understanding ROE. The formula for calculating return on equity is actually very simple. Take the company's net income and divide it by its total equity. You can find both of these numbers on a company's annual report. Let's take an example here real quickly, like Microsoft for 2007. I grabbed their annual report, and that says that their net income was $14.06 billion. And the total stockholders' equity was $31.1 billion. If we take the 14.06 and divide it by 31.1, we come up with 0.45. We move the decimal two places to the right and get 45%. So what does that really actually mean to us? Well, basically, for every dollar invested in a company, Microsoft earned 45 cents. This can be a very misleading statistic in the sense that it deals mainly with raw materials. Microsoft is a company that doesn't really have raw materials on hand. They use employees to make their software. So this would probably have more importance or significance to, say, a furniture company that has raw material on hand. So Microsoft would have a higher ROE based on not having raw materials, and a furniture company would have a lower ROE based on having inventory on hand. Any information provided here is for general informational purposes only and should not be considered an individualized recommendation or personalized investment advice. Any investments or strategies mentioned here may not be suitable for everyone. My name is Phillip Beningoso, and I'm an investment professional.